If you have a hard time seeing things clearly, maybe it's time for a prescription mask. After all, you spend all this time scuba diving to look at beautiful creatures. Shouldn't we see them clearly? Our diving would be much better if we could see everything that we wanted to see. So perhaps a prescription mask is what you need. Now, there's two types of vision problems people have, either being farsighted or nearsighted, perhaps both. Farsighted means that we can see objects in the distance clearly, but we have a hard time focusing up close, like reading a book, or in our case, reading our gauges. We're going to have some solutions for that a little later on, but first let's look at nearsighted. Nearsighted people, you can see up close, but things in the distance look blurry. So how are we going to solve that? Well, first we want to say if you're comfortable wearing contacts, there's no problem wearing your soft contacts when scuba diving. Obviously, you'd want to check with your optometrist, but many people use soft contacts when diving. But if you don't want to wear contacts, then perhaps the prescription mask again is your solution. In order to understand your prescription, let's take a look at one. You can see the rows going across the top. There's the OD and the OS. OD is basically a fancy Latin term for your right eye. OS is the left eye. The next column going over, we see SPH, which is short for sphere. So this person's right eye, the OD, has a minus 1.5 for the sphere, and the other eye has a minus 1.25. The next number going across, the CYL, that is cylinder. That has to do with an astigmatism. So if you have an astigmatism, it will show up there. This is a minus 0.50, which is a very slight astigmatism. The axis number also has to do with the astigmatism, but really won't affect us for what we're trying to do. So now here's the story. If that cylinder number is one or less, and in this case we have a 0.50, you probably can get away with dropping lenses instead of custom ground lenses. If doing custom ground lenses, you can do lenses that replace the entire lens in a mask, or you can also do what's known as bonded lenses. Bonded lenses really overall don't work out as well as a fully custom ground lens that replaces the lens in the mask, but many times if your prescription is very bad, the only way to really correct is with bonded lenses, or if you have a mask that has a complete lens across the front, not two individual lenses, then bonding is the only way to do it. But if you have a prescription where your astigmatism is not that great, a one or less, then drop-in lenses is really a great, inexpensive way for you to cure your vision problems for diving. Now, one of our favorite masks to put lenses in is one called a TUSA Splendive 2 or a TUSA Splendive 4. What's nice about this mask is bisymmetrical lenses. As you can see, the right lens is exactly the same as the left lens. This gives us a lot of advantages when putting together a mask for a customer. Let's take for an example somebody who needs a minus 2.5 in one eye and a minus 3 in the other eye. And then a year later, their eyes both get a little bit worse. Well, instead of having to start over with two brand new lenses, we can take the minus 3 out of one eye, shift it to the other one, and just sell them a single lens of 3.5 to round out their full prescription. So now let's take a look at how you would put lenses into this mask. The lenses are held in place by a retaining ring, and that retaining ring clips into the frame at a couple spots right there. You can see on the side of the nose those little discolorations. That's where the tab of the frame goes into the mask. There's actually four of them going all the way around the side. The way you want to take out the lenses is you have to remove this front retaining clip, which is easily done by taking a thumbnail and sliding it between the frame of the mask and the lens retaining ring. What you're doing is flexing that retaining ring slightly in toward the center of the lens, which lets that tab come out. Then what you want to do is lift up on it, which will disengage the bottom tab and the outside tab. Take a look, when I just give it a pull, you see, boom, it pops right out. We're going to do the exact same thing on the other side. Put a thumb nail right between the mask frame and the retaining ring. Lift up a little bit. Using your fingers, just give it a little pull, and boom, it'll pop right out. Here you can see all four of the little tabs that go into the mask frame. You can see it's kind of flexible, but it is plastic. You want to be a little careful that you don't crack this thing, but it is kind of forgiving. There's the four tabs going around, and they're on both sides. Now that we have the retaining ring out of there, all it takes is a little push on the back side of the lens, and they'll pop right out through the front. Now, it is possible that this little silicone seal sticks to the lens when it comes out. It's supposed to be in place right in the mask frame, and that's what's going to seal it. So you want to make sure that if that does come out, you simply put it back in and push it into place all the way around. We'll take out the other lens the exact same way, just a little push from the backside, and out it comes through the front. That's all there is to removing the lenses. So now what we want to do is grab our lenses, find the right one in order to put in each side. Here we've got two different lenses. We're going to open up one, and we're actually putting in a 2.5 and a 3 in this particular mask. So since they are bisymmetrical, either one can go in either side. We simply take the lens, put it into position, and kind of push it down so it seats into that silicone seal that we looked at earlier. We're going to do the same thing on the other side and just push them in there nice and firmly. You can look and make sure they seal all the way around, that you didn't pinch that seal. Then all we do is replace the retaining clip. The top tabs engage first. Just push up into the top, then work toward the outside clip next, then the one that's on the bottom, and then clip in the nose clip last. It's going to be the exact same procedure for the other side of the lens. Push the top tabs up into place, then push the outside tabs into place, do the bottom, then the one closest to the nose. If you take a close look at it, everything should be nice and flush and sealed. Another very popular mask is the Mari's X-Vision, or the Liquid Skin X-Vision. And you can see that these lenses are not bisymmetrical, but that's okay. You can just order a left and a right, and they'll go in basically the same way as they did with the Splendon. In the package that comes with the lenses, they actually give you a little tool to help separate the retaining ring from the frame. It's a little plastic thing. Don't use a metal screwdriver because you could crack the plastic. But by inserting this in there, then that helps you lift up the retaining ring if you don't have good enough thumbnails to do it. Then you just give a pull, everything will disengage, and the lenses go in the same way as they did with the Tusa. Now, obviously, if you order a mask and lenses from us at Scuba Toys, we're glad to put them together for you. But maybe your problem is not seeing in the distance, it's seeing up close. Well, there's a solution to that, too. There's a mask called a gauge reader. As you can see from this, they actually have built-in reading glasses in the bottom part of the lens. These are about a 1.75 reading glass, and it makes it a lot easier for you to see your gauges up close. Now, if you already have a mask and you don't want to buy a new one with a built-in gauge reader, you can buy aftermarket gauge readers. They're called dive optics. They come in different increments. You can get a 1.75, a 2, a 2.25, and as you can see here, they're going to magnify for you as well. These are real easy to drop into any mask that you already own. It's real important when installing them, though, that you follow the instructions properly. Make sure your glass is very, very clean. And there's a concave side to the lens. When you take a look, you'll see it kind of curves in on one side, out on the other. The concave side is going to go toward the lens. All you do is, after the lens is nice and clean, pour some water into the inside of the mask. Then by putting the concave side down on top of the water, you just give a push and it will push all the water out from underneath the lens, and the adhesion between the two of them will make it stick. It's not using an adhesive, it's just using the fact that it's basically created a vacuum in there on the concave side. I've seen these last in people's masks for years if they're installed properly. Be a little careful anytime you're putting defog in, but overall, this is another great option for you if you're having a hard time reading those gauges. So let's take a little look, a little overview here. If on your prescription your cylinder number is less than 1, you should be able to use drop-in standard lenses. If it's greater than 1, you probably have an astigmatism that will have to be solved with custom ground, be bonded or just custom ground drop-ins. If you're using just standard drop-ins, most of them come in 1/2 increments. Round up, if your prescription calls for a -2.75, go for the -3.0. And obviously, if you have any questions concerning what your options for a mask would be, don't hesitate to contact us at scubatoys.com. We'd love to be able to help you get your vision right for enjoying everything underwater. Okay, we'll see you. Get it? See ya?